Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being patient. We are running about 20 minutes behind schedule due to problems with overloading the school Wi-Fi system. We think we've solved the problem, so we're going to get cracking. I'm going to introduce to you Belle, who's going to then introduce the first performer. Thanks for your patience.
day that Benjamin's eyes left me, I felt the soul being ripped out of mine. New York's biggest socialite and businessman was gone. I must hide. This is where I'll stay. I'll stay here at our old square hotel for the rest of my time. The day that Benjamin left is the same day that I shut myself out from the world. He used to take me dancing. Introduced me to Abraham Lincoln himself. It's an honor to meet you. That was all gone. So, I live here now. And this is where I've been staying. With my darling little sister, who takes care of me. And I've never been happier. Father, please, I'm sorry. I understand that you told me to stop doing all of this, but I promise this was the last time. I understand. Last time you told me that I would never amount to anything otherwise. Marlon Brando, you have no right acting out these ridiculous lines. Do you realize how insane you look? You will never amount to anything different. Cut! Oh, that was exciting. Okay. I'll see you guys next week. Mr. Marlon Brando, how does it feel to be America's next rising actor? I must say, it's comforting, really. As weird as that sounds, my mother was a raging alcoholic who never had the time to care for me or my siblings. So to comfortably say that I can care for myself, it's definitely a good feeling. I want to thank you all for this award tonight. Michael Jackson, look at you. What a pop star you are. Marlon, when was the last time you were on set? Practice your lines with me while I think of some new moves, maybe. Since my last acting job, I have gained 300 pounds and was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes and liver cancer. Since then, this is how I live. Next, we have Zach Duckett, who will be doing prescribed structure, The Drifter.
Legends tell us of a time of when the bandits and outlaws reigned supreme, when the good men were shot dead and the women lived in fear. And in this time, a hero was hammered out, a daring and fearless bounty hunter, known only as the Drifter.
Our last episode left off with our hero racing after the train, chasing to save the beautiful damsel that was tied to the tracks. Will the Drifter be on a rescue in time, or is it too late for our damsel? Find out tonight on The Drifter.
Somebody help me, I'm tied to the tracks.
I'll save you. Ride like the wind! Yeah!
Don't worry, I got you.
Oh, sir, you saved my life. What's your name?
You can call me the Drifter. So the girl was saved and all is well, but little does the Drifter know that the folks back in town are in even greater danger for a notorious bandit, Deadshot Daniels, back in town.
Everyone listen up. My name is Deadshot Daniel, and from now on, I rule this town.
Don't even think about calling your savior the Drifter. He's been run over by a train. So if you could all hand over anything of worth, I'd be much obliged.
You're wrong, Daniel. The Drifter's not dead, he's alive. And if you think he's dead, then he's coming for you. He'll stop at nothing to you behind bars or dead.
Oh, ho, oh, oh. Ho! Is that so, old man? Hey, boys,
why don't we show this geezer what'll happen if the Drifter does show his face?
Go ahead, Daniel. Make my day.
Oh, ho, oh, oh. Ho! Bang!
Drifter, it's awful. You gotta save those people.
What do you want me to do, Mary? Ride in there on my horse, shoot them all up?
Well, I don't know, Drifter. You're the legend. How'd you save all those other people?
I rode in there on my horse and I shot him up.
He crossed the fields, he crossed the plains, he rode so fast, he dodged the rain. He was the Drifter. He came in town to save the day, his gun in hand, the only way. He was the Drifter. He was as sly as a fox, as strong as an ox, as quick as a hare, and as brave as a bear. He was the Drifter. He was the Drifter. He was the Drifter!
Oh, Mary, I can't believe that you saved those people. You gotta do the same for my town.
I would, Mary, but old Deadshot's too good of a name. I'd be Deadshot.
Well, you gotta do something.
I got another idea. Said this town had a bank, right?
Well, why, yes, Drifter, it does.
Good, good.
Stick him up! This is a robbery!
Oh, please, don't hurt me!
Empty that safe!
I'll do anything.
Justice, Daniel.
Drifter! You're still alive!
It's the Drifter!
He's back from the dead!
We're out of here!
Well, so am I.
What? Come back here, you cowards! It's one man!
Looks like your dates ran off on you, Daniel. Just you and me now.
I've worked too hard for this score! I'm not gonna let you take it away from me!
Hard way it is then.
Next time you kill me, better make sure I'm dead. Bang!
Oh, Drifter, you saved me again.
Whew. day's work, ma'am. So with a day saved, the drifter rides off into the sunset.
Hey-yo!
Next performing will be the music students.
Do you want to grab the grab that and we'll move as one?
As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, we have moved all the way from PA3 into PA4, or have we moved from PA4 into PA3? I'll let you decide. What we have, though, now is a selection of guitar from Ethan Zeckler. Thank you.
next up is Somi Pollock with performance structure number 8 and the character Irina Settler.
As I lay down to sleep, I pray the Lord my soul to keep, but if I die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take.
Good. But remember, it's 1, 2, 3. You see, it's absolutely crucial I check the sanitary conditions. Of course, I never got those exact qualifications. I'll blame the bench system. But I don't know. I don't understand. How can I save everyone if all you did was pretend to be a nurse? Well, my child, you're asking me to give up my child. If they come, they may not. You're just a nurse. What is the guarantee? There is none. But there won't be a tomorrow. Tomorrow. We'll operate tomorrow. You lose a lot of blood. Blood. Blood on my hands. Our hands if we go back fast. Fast. A blood transfusion is needed fast. We need to give them every possible chance to survive. Survive. These children deserve every possible chance to survive. All we need is the van. Name, name, address. After it's all over, I can reunite them. You can reunite them. But it's just a jar. Elliot Tarkovska, whipped in, 6 months old, taken to America. Stanislava Busseldorf mothered her. And I and Yosel Kapow were her parents. Over 3 million injections, 2.4 million babies saved, and 1,100 donations. Mr. Harris, even through your fear of needles, you still managed to save all these children. Well, what do you have to say for yourself? One of my talents, perhaps my only talent, is that I can be a blood donor. I was just doing what's normal. I don't know. You gave them clothes, food, and money.
in here to sell. Where are you keeping the juice? Sell. If you're such a good nurse, why can't you walk? In a line. Helena, you're here. I was Yolanda.
And back in music again, we have Miss Lily Shepherd, accompanied by Christian Meyer, and she'll be singing selections from her exam next week.
From the moment I met them, knew you were mine. Next performer is Isabel Elliott performing Prescribed Structure Number 10. The character is Mary Poppins.
Oh, is that the time? I heard this family isn't the easiest. Oh, they never are. Marissa, I want to No, darling, Mummy's busy. Do not interrupt me.
Veruca, I said no, I do not want to see you right now. Go outside. Mary Poppins, do not tell me how to parent my child. Veruca!
I would love that castle, and thank you. I'm doing my best. 5 more weeks, isn't that exciting? 2nd one, can't wait for this thing to come out of me. Timmy, he should be down the street playing with Michael, maybe John, God only knows. What a nice little room I'll be staying in. Quite clean, I'm sure you can help me keep it this clean. First things first, let's clean this atrocious playroom of yours. I did not take no for an answer, Veruca. That is not how I was raised. Come on, up we get. Who do you think I am, poor? I do not want to clean this room. You were not hired to tell me what to do. I want to play a game. Play a game with me. I will not clean this room. Play a game with me. A game you want, a game you'll get. In every job that must be done, there's an element of fun. Find that fun and scrap. That job's a game. Count with me. 1, 2, 3. Spotless. Billy, what are we going to do? What's your father going to say when he finds out you're a homosexual? We've got to go to the church tomorrow, but run along. Your father cannot see you. And remember, Hermione will babysitting you guys tonight. But I don't want to, Mrs. Poppins. I shouldn't have to. It's not my fault. It never is. I do not want to apologize. Fine. Mother. Good evening, Mother. Mrs. Poppins said I should apologize to you for the way I've been acting. So I am sorry. I was just bored. I didn't mean it. Do you forgive me? Well, Veruca, only if you're sincere. Mrs. Poppins and I have been talking. Maybe tomorrow we could go to the park? Please do not touch anything at that park. You do not want to be like all the other children. Come on, Veruca, bedtime. Left leg, right leg, pull them up. Arms up, pull it down, brush your teeth. All done. Good night, sweet dreams.
Mrs. Poppins, how do you expect to save this family?
You and I both know I don't save families, but rather help them. We just need to make sure Veruca does not turn out like her mother. Are we all set for today? What a lovely day it is today. Veruca, go over there and play with the young little girls. But please, darling, do not touch anything. Mary Poppins, is that you? Mrs. Poppins, how does it feel working for the Stults? How does it feel to be the number one nanny in the world? I'm sure there's words that can't describe it. Oh, on the contrary, there's a perfect word to describe it, but it's for another day. It's a beautiful day and I'll be on my way. Mommy, look! Look at the pigeons! The pigeons that Mrs. Poppins told us about! Please, can we go feed them? Don't you remember Mrs. Poppins? Please, Mommy, please. I'll pay! It's not a waste of money, please! I want to feed the birds! All the other kids get to feed the birds, why can't I? Mrs. Poppins, please. Please. It's quite all right, Veruca. Come on, let's go home. You've got to respect your mother's wishes.
Mom, leave me alone! You know I'm texting Michael!
Mom, take a chill pill. You know I'm not doing anything stupid.
Marissa, I said I wanted a golden goose. What is this? This is pink. But it will do, I guess. Thank you. Hiram, why is that red? I said green apple. Oh my gosh. Thank you, I guess. There, I'll eat it anyway.
Ha, that's gratitude for you. Didn't even get a thank you. You know she likes you more than you. You know she likes your mother more than you.
As she should. We best be on our way. Oh, what's that? A letter from the Malfoys. We better be on our way.
watching now? Ah, cool. Do we introduce ourselves?
Yeah, I'm Jacob Rover. I am 19 years of age. I'm playing two songs for you. They're both old gypsy jazz songs from Paris. A guy called Django Reinhardt, I'm sure some of you heard of him, he's quite famous. Did a lot of jazz stuff, and I played two of them. One's Tears, which is more of a sad, melancholy song. A ballad, maybe. And then the second one would be a swing, minor swing, which is another famous song. Would you call, is that from the jazz repertoire?
Yes.
Yes, so minor swing is in the jazz repertoire. We need to start playing? All right, let's do it.
Great.
Swing. And I apologize because I was a little out of tune, but that's all right. And this song is Tears. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go offline for about 5 minutes. Our next performance is at 3:30, so we have actually caught up. That will allow us to see if we can reconfigure the system so that we can avoid any more lagging in the next hour. Okay, thanks very much.
Cool.
They loved it, didn't they?
Oh,
I think
brave,
I could hear one.
They're brave.
Yeah.
Like,
exactly.
Is
that faces on the other
side?
You broke
faces on the
other
side.
It was quiet outside. You know why?
Yeah.
Even the birds had stopped to listen.
Ah, yeah. That's it. How many people were watching, by the way?
I think for you, it jumped up to 182.
Wow. As opposed to 181.
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
See you, Jacob.
You've got a couple of minutes here, so you don't have to check out.
performer is Libby Cowley doing the prescribed structure of Mary Poppins. Please enjoy.
Disorder, catastrophe, anarchy. In short, we have a ghastly mess. Well, it seems I'll have my work cut out for me this time. Must we go? This family has a fearful reputation. Fearful reputation. Bish-bosh. The door is wide open and those children need me. The letter sums it up perfectly. Now, come along. I can feel the wind picking up. How does it feel to finally be working for the dark side? Mary Poppins, how long have you personally known the Skywalkers? Mary Poppins, is it true you're single? Really? One never discusses the relationship status of a lady. Now, if you'll excuse me. Right. Ah, Mr. Vader! I received your letter discussing the terrible conditions your home was in and came at once. We can discuss payment options at a later date, of course. However, I will require every second Tuesday off. Here are my qualifications.
I never summoned you, Nanny. Who's your commander? Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, we had some technical difficulties. Next up is Libby Cowley with the prescribed structure of Mary Poppins. Please enjoy.
Thanks, Belle.
Disorder, catastrophe, anarchy. In short, we have a ghastly mess. Well, it seems I'll have my work cut out for me this time. Must we go? This family has a fearful reputation. Fearful reputation, bish-bosh. The door is wide open and those children need me. The letter sums it up perfectly. Now, come along. I can feel the wind picking up. Luke, Leia, what have I told you about playing with the Force while Daddy's working? Finally be working for the dark side. Mary Poppins, how long have you personally known the Skywalkers? Mary Poppins, is it true you're single? Really? One never discusses the relationship status of a lady. Now, if you'll excuse me. Right. Ah, Mr. Vader! I received your letter discussing the terrible conditions your home was in and came at once. We can discuss payment options at a later date, of course. However, I would require every second Tuesday off. Here are my qualifications.
I never summoned a nanny. Who's your commander? They must have the wrong address. I'm afraid not, Mr. Vader. However, I'd be happy to work for a week's trial basis. In the meantime, it seems you're running quite late for work. Don't worry about the house. I'll have it spick and span by the time you arrive. The children are in good hands. Don't forget your Death Star plans.
Luke, Leia. Come downstairs at once, please. Who are you? Yeah, what are you doing here? I'm Mary Poppins, and I'm here to restore order to your lovely home. So, first order of business, cleaning the playroom. Luke, you'll do the sweeping. Leia, you'll do the scrubbing. And I, bookshelf, and no using the force. We want to do this manually. She used the force! You used the force! That's totally not fair! Luke, what nonsense are you talking about? Get back to cleaning, please. Leia, if you continue to make up stories, you'll be going to bed early. Now, Spitzbot, we have a lot to do today. Tick, tock, tick, tock. Well, would you look at the time? Luke, Leia, bedtime, quickly. But it's only 8:30. Yeah, Daddy lets us stay up till 10. We're not babies, you know. No, but you're young children who need your rest. So, watching closely, please. Toothpaste, toothbrush, teeth. Up, down, left, right, turn around, freeze. Now, repeat for 2 minutes, then move on to pajamas. Watching me. Right, leg, left, leg, arms up, over the head, done. Now run along, put your pajamas on like I taught you, and if you're quick and quiet about it, I might even read you a bedtime story. Luke, Leia, I'm her. Luke, Leia, what's going on? Why can I see the floor? Mr. Vader, please try to keep your voice down. The children are asleep. Asleep? It's barely 8:30. Precisely. Now, Mr. Vader, I've been thinking not only to the children need my help, but so do you. So I plan the presentation. Please take a seat and watch closely as we go through our first parenting style. Fall in! Friedrich, you disobeyed my orders. And you know what happens when you disobey my orders. Friedrich, you know how this house runs. Discipline, dominance, rules. And you broke those rules. So, you must be punished. And, now Friedrich, I promise you, I take no pleasure in this. I'm sorry, Father. I mean, Captain. It won't happen again. So, Mr. Vader, what did we learn from this parenting style? Well, it seems like something I could really work with. Discipline, dominance, rules. I mean, what's the point in ruling the galaxy when you can't even rule your own home, right? Not quite what I was going for, Mr. Vader, but good try. We'll move on to our next parenting style. This is one we want to avoid at all costs. Robert, where's my drink? Get me my drink, Robert, now! Hello, police. I'd like to report a commotion from my neighbor's house. Banging, crashing, and lots of yelling. Yes, children are on site. Mr. Vader, please tell me what we need to avoid as a parent. I must not rely on substances when I struggle at work. Yes, and no! We'll move on to our last parenting style, Mr. Vader. Please try and pay close attention. Maddie! I got us mother and daughter jackets for the competition! Here's yours. Mine says, I'm Maddie's mom. I'm so proud of you, Maddie. We're gonna smash those candy apples right in their faces. I'm so proud of us. I mean you, for getting top of the pyramid. Thanks, Mom, for the jacket and everything, but I don't want to do this anymore. I want to find my own thing. Maybe try acting or traveling by myself, without you. So you want me to smother my kids? No, Mr. Vader. Each parenting style has a different lesson to be learned. Parenting style number one. Children need boundaries, but they do not need corporal punishment. Parenting style number two. A child's well-being comes first, and when you're struggling, you must ask for help. And parenting style number three. You need to spend time with your children, but if you force them into it, you'll push them away further than where they begun. So, Mr. Vader, which parenting style are you? Oh, welcome back to Which Parenting Style Are You? Today's guest, Mr. Darth Vader, spin the wheel. 1, 2, 3, I think we have a winner. Last night, and I was thinking, we don't spend enough time together. So, after you've done your teeth and had your breakfast, no making a mess this time, Luke, I thought we'd go on a tour of the Death Star and blow up some Ewoks. How does that sound? Order has been restored to the galaxy. Difficulties, everyone.
Everyone, I'd like to introduce our next drama student, Bianca, who is going to be doing the prescribed structure of Ida Wood. Immediately.
What a dream. Mr. Wood, sir.
May 28th, 1856.
Yours sincerely, Ida.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Miss Ida Mayfield invited to her first ball, where she meets George Washington then. Pleasure to meet you. May I have his dance? What's this? Extra, extra, read all about it. Miss Ida Mayfield, soon to be married to Benjamin Wood. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Extra, read all about it. Tragedy, as Sir Benjamin Wood is found dead. Dead. It's gone. My one true love is gone. It's been taken away from me. These were the flowers that we had on our wedding day. And they're now for you, my love. These memories. Why do they keep playing in my head? Get them out of my head. I can't take it. Benjamin, Emma, Mary, extra, read all about it. Miss Ida Wood, found after 24 years. Please, somebody help me. My sister, she's dying. Anybody, I'm in room 552, can you hear me? Please, anyone, please, my sister. That was the last time that I ever saw you. That was when I became alone. It's here in my thoughts with all these memories going around. Benjamin, I remember when we always danced around to our ABBA CDs together. Listen to the songs such as Dancing Queen. And how can we forget money? Read all about it. Miss Agneta Faltcourt, found after 17 years.
Something that I will not go back to. responsibility. All that I want to me but to walk away.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next up, we have Lily Shepherd doing the prescribed structure of Frida Kahlo. Enjoy.
Jess Kennedy, could you please ensure that you come past the general office before leaving tonight and collect a parcel that's on the bench for you, please?
Welcome to The Splash with Ryan Seacrest. Britney Spears, guys. If no one's gonna talk about her, I will. Okay, what happened to America's Little Sweetheart? Okay? Really? She's been acting really slutty. And a little bit skanky. Really? I mean, we want the old Britney back. And they say she's so lucky. She's a star, but she cries, cries, cries on her kitchen floor, saying, why do these tears fall down? Good night, America! You know, in my life, I've had two accidents. First one being my bus crash.
All aboard!
Guys, Amy Winehouse, come on. Amy, I've been a fan for years, but what is going on with the drugs? Girl, you need to calm down. It is getting embarrassing to watch.
I only said goodbye with words. I died 100 times. You go back to her and I go back.
Rest in peace, Amy Winehouse. We lost an angel today. Ryan Seacrest on The Splash, everybody. Whitney Houston, come on. You know, I have been a Whitney fan for, geez, years. Years, I have loved her, but Whitney, she's been acting like a lunatic recently. I mean, the drugs, the alcohol, Bobby Brown. Please, what is going on?
And
Dios mio, Mom! I've had enough. I have had enough. I will marry Diego. Why? Why? Because I love him. I'm not listening. I'm not listening to anything you're telling me. The affairs, well, he's changed.
two of them. Two!
Never wanted to listen to anything I told her. Very brave, very courageous. Dressed a little bit different. I don't know. Well, I always love her, but you know, she will do what she wants to do. That's just Frida.
Frida Kahlo, Olivia Wiseman on the crest. Frida, please tell me, have you ever considered a modeling career? That monobrow speaks wonders to me. I mean, I have never felt more spiritually connected to anybody until the moment I saw you with that brow. It was truly incredible. Disparates! Me? A fashion model. A fashion icon. Frida encourages other women to abandon expectations and live as they desire.
Okay, thanks, ladies and gentlemen. As you can probably tell, we're back in the music area. Our next performer will be Jack, and as you can guess, because they weren't here before, he's going to be playing drums. He's just got a couple of things to set up with. In the meantime, I'd like to thank you for tuning in and for putting up with some of the buffering issues. I'm going to leave the camera on here, and you'll see him doing his final moments of setup and preparation.